Welcome back to this video lecture series on programming questions for placement preparation. So today the problem we're going to look for is the implement queue as stack. Again, whenever we are learning about queue, this is a very important question to know, because most of the times and often we see that this question is being asked in your placement experience. So let's start. So the problem will be given a task to create a queue and show its contents. Implement the queue operation in terms of stack. So let's have a look at the approach. So the approach will be almost similar to the way we implemented stack using queues. What we do here is we keep two stacks here, S1 and S2, let's name them, and the aim is to keep push operation of queue as unchanged. We will do some alteration in the pop operation. So first, when element is pushed, then it will be just a normal push operation. For the push operation, we'll just invoke the main stack and we'll say that invoke the push operation for the stack. That's it. So the push will be very normal. What we have to do, the main trick comes when we encounter the pop operation. So when an element is to be popped, first check that whether stack S1 is empty or not. So one thing to notice here, that S1 will be the active stack here. S2 will be used as a dummy stack, like an auxiliary stack kind of. So if S1 is not empty, then until its size is 1, we pop all the elements out of S1 and push it to S2. And lastly, after coming out of the loop, we'll be left with only one element in S1. What we will do, we'll pop it out. After doing that, we will swap S1 and S2. So that's the pop operation. Now two more operations are there for the queue. One is the front element, to get the front element, and to get the element at rear. So to get the element at rear, it's very simple. We just need to fetch the top of the stack. And to get the front, what we do, we again do the similar kind of operation as pop. So we check whether the size of this one is 1 or not. Until that, we pop it and push the elements to S2. Then we are left with only one element in S1, and that is the front element of the queue, and we just show it. So let's jump on to the programming part and see how we can do it. So here is the ID, and what I'm going to do, I'm again going to make a class and I'm going to name it queue. So here we're going to have private data members. The first will be the size of the queue, and I'm going to initialize with 0, and we'll be having two stack here. So these stack data type is already provided in C++. You know, this is under the STL libraries. Like, we have this flexibility of using the standard template libraries in C++, that we can actually invoke all the stack operations with fewer lines than C. So I'm going to take two stacks here, S1 and S2. Now in the public part, what we are going to have is we are going to have the functions. So the first function would be the push. So let me just write it. The argument will be an integer. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to first increase the size, and I'm going to invoke this S1 stack and say push x, as simple as that. Now it comes when we will do all the operations in the pop operation. So this is the function signature. Now I'm going to define it. First I need to check whether the stack is empty or not. So S1 is empty or not. If it is empty, then what I'm going to return, just return, I say like do nothing. And now if it is not empty, then I'll run a loop which says while S1 dot size is not equals to 1, what I'm going to do is I'm going to push to S2 all the elements of the S1. So to invoke that, I'm going to use the stop operation and pop that element from S1. Now after that, we'll be left with only one element and in S1, and that is the desired element to be popped from the actual queue. So what we do, S1 dot pop. Now S1 is empty, and now what we need to do, as S2 is the auxiliary stack, so we need to swap these two stacks. So I'm going to take a stack variable here, and I'm going to store S1 here. then s1 is equal to s2 and s2 is equal to s. Pretty clear. This is the pop operation. Now, okay, sorry, get rear and get front. So let me just first define this get rear function. So for the get rear, we just need to return the top of the stack s1. So before that, we're going to check if the stack s1 is empty or not. If it is empty, we're going to return -1, okay, which indicates that the stack is empty. And if it is not, then we're going to return s1 dot top. And now the get front method. So here again, I'm going to check for that condition whether the stack is empty or not. So if it is empty, then I'm going to return a -1 here. Otherwise, I'm going to actually copy this part. Because I told you that the operations will be almost similar to the pop operation. So here it is. Now before doing that, what we do, okay, one thing in pop operation, before doing this s1.pop, we need to actually decrease the size. Okay, so here I'm going to take a temporary variable temp, and I'm going to store the last element, okay, that is top. And then I can s1.pop, and after all these swapping things, I'm going to return this temp. The last function that we will be actually implementing here is the get size of the stack. So get size, what it will do, it will return the current value of the size. So the class definition is complete. So here I'm going to make an object of this Q class, and I'm going to use four push operations. So here goes the first. Fourth. The values will be this. And now we're going to first do a pop operation. Before that, we're going to see out size, and this will, we will invoke the get size method, okay. And here end. So after popping, what we will do, we'll check for the front and the rear element. So we're going to see out front q dot get front handle, then the rear, so q dot get rear, and lastly we'll again see the size of the queue. So let's copy and paste it here. And before every pop, we'll print down this message popping. So now we're going to do one more pop operation and see what happens. Okay, so let's now run this. So here's the output. First, the size is 4 because we didn't do any pop operation. Then after one pop operation, then after one pop operation, as 1 was entered first, so it will be deleted. So 2 will be at front and 4 will be at rear, and the size will be obviously decremented by 1, so 3. Then another pop operation, so now 2 will be popped and 3 will be at front, 4 will be at rear, the size will be 2. So as we can see, this is the perfect way to implement a queue using stacks. Thank you for watching this video and staying with us. See you next time.